Many professors, researchers, think tank scholars, academics, and even members of Congress are confused about the subject of China. Some people who profess to have thorough knowledge of this entire matter are quite vehement in claiming that there are two Chinas. We are forced to ask, why does the U.S. executive branch insist on saying that there is only one China? Let's go back to the year of 2004, testifying before the House International Relations Committee on April 21, 2004, Assistant Secretary of State for East Asian and Pacific Affairs, James Kelly, was asked to explain the underlying rationale for the One China policy. He was unable to do so. Unfortunately, from 2004 to the present, no U.S. State Department officials have offered any further detailed remarks on this important issue. This is very puzzling to many people. In fact, the U.S. executive branch's insistence on one China can only be explained by reference to a branch of international law, which is largely unknown to most civilians. That is, the laws of war and their subset, the laws of occupation. With no knowledge of this branch of law, most persons assume that the dispute over two Chinas arose due to the Chinese Civil War of the 1940s. However, this conceptualization of the subject is in error. More accurately, the Taiwan question must be understood as an issue left over from World War II in the Pacific. Looking back at the history of World War II, many of the so-called China experts seem to acquiesce to the idea that Chiang Kai-shek of the Republic of China could define the significance of the October 25, 1945 Japanese surrender ceremonies in Taiwan any way he wanted. At those ceremonies, CKS military officers said that the sovereignty of Taiwan now belonged to China and proclaimed Taiwan Retrocession Day. Under the laws of war, however, which include the Geneva Conventions, Hague Conventions, and other established international precedent, such an explanation is impossible. The surrender ceremonies only mark the beginning of the military occupation. The conqueror has the right and indeed the obligation to conduct the military occupation of conquered territory, to delineate any transfer of territorial sovereignty, a formal peace treaty is necessary. All military attacks, or at least 99.5% against Taiwan in the World War II period, were made by U.S. military forces. But General MacArthur delegated the administrative authority for the occupation to the Chinese nationalists under CKS. Japanese sovereignty continued after October 1945, since the San Francisco Peace Treaty did not come into effect until April 28, 1952. Notably, the SFPT designates the USA as the principal occupying power. With the above information, we can quickly make three important observations. First, beginning October 25, 1945, the ROC was only exercising delegated administrative authority for the military occupation of Taiwan. Second, in December 1949, when the ROC moved its central government to occupied Taiwan, it was moving outside of Chinese national territory. Third, with the coming into force of the peace treaty in 1952, the Allies have disbanded. However, the United States, i.e. the principal occupying power, has assented tacitly or otherwise to pre-existing arrangements for continuing the military occupation of Taiwan. In other words, the ROC is serving as a proxy occupation force for the USA, in addition to maintaining its status as a government in exile. At this point, two questions may be asked. Number one, is Taiwan a part of the ROC? Number two, is Taiwan a part of the PRC? In fact, The U.S. executive branch has never recognized the forcible incorporation of Taiwan into the territory of the Republic of China or the People's Republic of China. Hence, the answer to these two questions should be very clear. Relevant documentation is as follows. Taiwan is not part of the ROC. In the case of Shung versus Rogers, D.C. Circuit, October 6, 1959, quoting from official pronouncements of the Department of State, the judges held that the provisional capital of the Republic of China has been at Taipei, Taiwan since December 1949. That the government of the Republic of China exercises authority over the island. That the sovereignty of Formosa has not been transferred to China. And that Formosa is not a part of China as a country. At least not as yet. And not until and unless appropriate treaties are hereafter entered into. Formosa may be said to be a territory or an area occupied and administered by the government of the Republic of China, but it is not officially recognized as being a part of the Republic of China. Taiwan is not part of the PRC. In the Congressional Research Service report, China-Taiwan, Evolution of the One China Policy dated July 9, 2007, the following points were made. 1. The United States did not explicitly state the sovereign status of Taiwan in the three U.S. PRC joint communiques of 1972, 1979, and 1982. 2. The United States acknowledged the One China position of both sides of the Taiwan Strait. 3. U.S. policy has not recognized the PRC's sovereignty over Taiwan. 4. U.S. policy has not recognized Taiwan as a sovereign country. And 5. U.S. policy has considered Taiwan's status as undetermined. In conclusion, the People's Republic of China, founded October 1, 1949 in Beijing, is the sole legitimate government of China. Taiwan does not belong to China, nor is it an independent entity. Taiwan is an occupied territory of the United States of America. Does this mean that Taiwan belongs to the United States? The answer is no. Taiwan's legal status is a type of quasi-USA trusteeship under military government within the U.S. insular law framework. Hopefully, U.S. executive branch officials can be more precise in explaining the underlying rationale behind the One China policy in the near future.
伊这资料来源是伫遮，这毋是咱做哦，毋是咱民政府做哦。好，谢谢。好，来，这讲得足清楚的，全世界就一个中国，中华人民共和国。啊，个美国军事占领台湾 ，ROC 是流亡来台湾的。哦，这几个重点，流亡政府不得就地合法。伊就是讲中华民国来遮外久，一百单两百单对啊，他也不是我们，伊嘛是流亡政府，伊嘛袂使是咱台湾人的政府，台湾人的政府。伊他要合法会使，你不要他合法，你怎么知？他怎么合法？等于中国，不是，伊也等于中国，对啊，嘛，好，占领不得移转主权、主权。即马美国底下照顾伊嘛，未使移转咱的主权，所以讲民主起来以后。 美国军事占领，伊若稳成稳家了稳定以后，他也会离开，不是离开就会，先占等我们稳定政权以后，他会撤退台湾，不是撤退台湾，就是可能跟我们签一个什么的哈，然后他继续在掌控，在这边掌控古约亚太啊呢，所以他才会在我们这边台北内湖金湖路100号内湖那叫什么？在台北的迄个金湖路100号，金湖路，金湖，这边站设立一个亚太最大的指挥中心底下。啊，我继续各位看一个影片吼，也是咱伫美国，咱秘书长夫人，包括咱董先底下开一个国际记者会。记者俱乐部，美国国际记者俱乐部，但是这新闻伫大陆封锁的，拢无的，哦，麻烦一下。
I'd like to begin by introducing Mrs. Lin.
太阳花学院迄陈文婷嘛伫遮开哦，伊拢有出现，但是咱无。
So Mrs. Julian T. A. Lin was born in Taiwan. She grew up in a native Taiwanese family. Her parents are just victims of the ROC's 1946 international decrees.Since her childhood, she has witnessed many unequal treatments of the people of Taiwan and wished one day that she could improve the justice for the Taiwanese people. After she married Dr. Roger Lin, she became a volunteer to fight for human rights for the people of Taiwan. Over the past 60 years, the inhabitants of Taiwan were in political purgatory. They have lived without any uniformly recognized government and nationality.She refuses to continually endure the ROC's unfair treatments that the people of Taiwan have been suffering from after World War II. This time, Mrs. Julian Lin and her husband together sue the United States and the Republic of China in order to relieve Taiwan from the regime violating the human rights. Eventually, the goal is to achieve the normalization of the Taiwan international status.May I please introduce Mrs. Julian Lin.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Julian Lin. It is my honor to make these brief remarks to you and all the world on behalf of myself, my husband, Dr. Roger Lin.And the 30,000 members of the Taiwan civil government, which filed a lawsuit for a declaratory judgment on February 27, 2015, in the United States District Court for the District of Columbia. Our lawsuit was filed here in Washington.When it was February 28th in Taiwan. That day is the National Day of Mourning and the Remembrance by the people of Taiwan of what is known as the 228 incident or 228 massacre. Beginning on February 27th, 1947, Taiwanese protesters.Were violently suppressed by the KMT-led Republic of China. When the killing began on February 28th, many thousands of civilians lay dead. This is how the KMT's white terror period in Taiwan began, a period in which thousands more disappeared. The 228 massacre.Is one of the most important and personal events in our modern Taiwanese history. When my husband, friends, my co-workers, and I think of these events of the past, we think of also of our present. When we think of our desire to no longer be stateless,In 1946, the ROC nationality decrees imposed upon the people of Taiwan without the consent of the people of Taiwan, a nationality of the Republic of China. This is a nationality that he never offered the people of Taiwan an internationally accepted nationality. We seek a declaration that the nationality decrees of 1946 violated international law, illegally depriving the plaintiffs of a recognized nationality. We seek a declaration that the nationality decrees of 1946 were delivered and enforced without the authority of the United States. We seek a declaration that the nationality decrees of 1946 stripping the people of Taiwan of their Japanese nationality and imposing a nationality of ROC are invalid. Our fight is the district court here in Washington, D.C. It's about decrees that were enacted decades ago that violated international law and have affected our lives every day ever since. On a human level, this lawsuit is about the personal identities of my friends and family, my co-workers and organizations members, and all the people of Taiwan in this world. We do not have a nationality that affords us the same basic privileges as most of the citizens of this world. We do not have a nationality that we or our parents or grandparents were able to have a say in. Imagine that going to bed with one nationality and waking up with a new one, being told, no, you cannot keep your home and the identity you once had, being told, no, this new identity that you never asked for, never agreed to is not settled, cannot be settled anytime soon, being told. Nearly everyone else in this world may have a nationality that allows him or her the opportunity to travel freely and then to come home and to belong. But you cannot. There is the basic sense of not belonging completely anywhere, and we have lived with this now for generations. It is frustrating and painful to know that we are in this situation because of a decision made so many years ago to change an entire population's national identity overnight. It is frustrating and painful to know that we have international rights that are supposed to protect us and our families, and that the decision to take away an entire population's nationality has been allowed to stand, to hold us for so many years. These international protections are very important to us, and I will read you now just one of them. As it is written, Article 15 of the Universal Declaration of Human Rights states, first, everyone has the right to a nationality. Second, no one should be arbitrarily deprived of his nationality, nor denied the right to change his nationality. I am proud to stand here today and represent our fight to invalidate these nationality decrees. I am proud to stand here today and represent our fight to exercise our right of self-determination to determine for ourselves and our national identity is. There are many wrongs, many tragedies of the past which may cause us pain even today, but which we cannot undo. The nationality decrees of 1946 are a real kind of wrong, injustice, which we believe can be undone. We intend now to fight to undo them. God bless American. God bless Taiwanese. Thanks for all your coming, and please support human rights for us. Thank you very much.
谢谢。这个是我们缪长夫人3月12号到我们台湾民众的同心去美国开了记者会，这个记者里面没有台湾的，全部都是外国人，全部外国记者。当天的网路上观看的，那天看的人数就1800多万人，后面陆续一直增加。但是台湾你敢在没有这个消息，也没有这个新闻，拢无。太阳花他们也是在这边开的哦，太阳学院嘛，以他们要求，两个中国，要求美国要两个中国，一个中华民国，啊嘞，但伊拢有新闻，但是咱无，哎呀，是严重在封锁，嗯，啊，刚感到。讲到国籍哈，刚刚夫人讲的国籍，国籍是可以被令不知道状况下更改吗？可以吗？不可以，为什么？人权，对，侵犯人权。你像外籍新娘或外国人，他要在台湾住满几年，然后以后住满几年以后，他要更改他的国籍，是他要自愿、自动合法。某可能讲伊来家带过了改改啊，不可能，在人权上是讲不过去，不可能的，是违法的。所以中华民国在台湾所有的行为，讲白点都是违法国际法，违反国际法的，哎呀，伊那即马，中华民国伊为什么不敢针对我们，不敢跟我们面对面？下面来讲，伊拢做违法的代志啊，抽水嘛是啊，抽水啊，即马恁乌多拜水有无？有无？我都拜有抽水无？有哈啊！较早有无？较早敢有？较早无？好像去年还是去年开始的哈，伊就寄予你叫要抽个乌多拜的水啊，好不好？哎呀，你敢知？你们知道吗？有啊，有多一条。以前没有，对不对？以前没有，对吧？啊，伊甲你增加这些税，你唔知呢？你们去看有这条，哎呀，不知道去年还是什么时候增加的，哎呀，去年开始哈，哎，去年开始啊，嘿，对对对对，嘿，哎，哎卡，啊，你要一起缴哦，他不是，哎，伊唔是讲分开哦，都拜个黑了，加在一起，啊，你强制你就要去纳这条，对啊，所以伊在甲你撮合你嘛唔知啊，他在增加这些的时候，他不会告诉你台湾人啊，哎呀。所以说台湾存这条路啊，存台湾民政府咱的法律这条，那不啊哈，没有别条路，中民进党就好啊。到即马一到中华民国，伫咱台湾嘛是伫遐选举尔啊。我们有的同心他是民进党的哈，他有接触，有的跟民进党有的较高层的立法委员嘛也有接触啊，他们也有跟他们讲民政府啊。你嘛讲，我知啊，我嘛知民政府啊。我嘛知美国军事占领台湾啦，但是伊讲一句话，阮国要选举的呢，系啊，所以你们要很了解清楚，都一样啦。讲到这些，讲到法律，讲到啥，伊心内有数啊，伊嘛知，伊嘛讲讲咧，中华民国无，伊嘛知呢，他们也知道中华民国没有啦，无啊。所以讲嘛有人在讲啊，啊，美国会搞民进党未？敢未？你们认为会不会？为什么？嘿。没有法律依据啊，他又登记在中华民国体制下啊，他又拿中华民国的身份证啊，如果美国交给他，他又回到中华民国手上，够可怜。哎呀，他如果要他必须要解，比如说 他如果为了台湾，只要为了台湾，爱咱们这翻译是健康的，他可以把他们的人来这边上课，然后重新把民进党解散啊，然后重新来为台湾一起打拼啊。谢拉伯爱，为什么不要？哎呀，他们就是有共同利益。嘿，对啊。哎呀，给干嘛蹭？哎呀，哎呀，所以讲讲要选举啊，因为选举你没有那个啊，有啊，提举后裔啊，为了选举，为了台湾啊，所以讲台湾人民很可怜，政党嘛在搞恁骗钱，哎呀，啊，你们基层一般人民百姓就讲，为了台湾，马进倒沙冈，倒沙冈，结果落尾咧，何康是赢啦，你敢有丢掉什么何康诶？你若要做一个清洁队员，你嘛要提举后裔呢，有影无？哎呀。对啊，所以讲都赶快啦，所以你们一定要认清楚、认知台湾民主这条路是100%正确的，也没有别条路可以走了，只有这条路可以救台湾，哎，告美国，哎呀、啊，就身份证方面的，嘿嘿。嘿嘿，还没，赶快就是咱过过去调啊，咱调，咱我们的国籍被改啊，我们不能强加这中华民国国籍啊，这调了跑来调的弄倒啊，哎呀，调就是讲意思讲中华民国就是无啊。28这我阁无啥了解，你即摆得等伊的回复看卖啊，系啊，系啊。哦 ，S 二，我们是2月28那天提出。好、嗯、好、哦哦，是啊，哎、欸、嘿，啊中哎、欸，他们就是要延缓啦、啊，中华民国美国啊，是啊，但是伊拖也无效啦，绝对迄个美国法院也判迄个嘛。
也就是说，因的法官是独立的，
嘿嘿，司法没受台湾安呢？
哦，不受政府控制哦。
嘿，不会不会，他们是司法跟行政都是那个的分开的，嘿、哦、啊，所以讲伊无法度啊。不，哎，对啊，来啊。所以讲，咱当时到2009年判决的时候吧，第一次的时阵，美国地方要求判决内底有一条，就是美国诶行政单位要协助本土台湾人，就台湾民政府。
所以
买赔，美国爱赔啊，这个。嘿嘿，啊，美国无迄个提议钱来赔啊，一定叫中华民国掏啊。系啊，对啊。啊，即摆所以讲，咱美国嘛要求爱办身份证，啊，本土台湾身份证就是一定要有迄个日治时代的。啊，日治时代即摆爱去复制，复政事务所爱申请迄个日治时代，但是最近有一个阮有诶复政朋友在讲啦，伊家己收到诶，甲阮头讲诶，即摆可能9月份以后要办即个日治时代嘿，可能无遐好办啦，嘿，这是私底下咱伊含阮在讲，嘿啊，你也知道，你也知哦，3.7以内。嘿啊，不可以委托，是不是？他可能限制很多啦。嘿，调岗的呀，嘿，调岗的呀，嘿呀。
对。
啊，你哪在？对啊。你哪在？啊？问过了哈，嘿，对啊。嘿，这属实就9月1号啊。嘿，困兽之斗，他可以拖，讲白点，他现在拖多久算多久，可以吸多少钱就可以吸。嘿。对啊，当然了，如对啊，啊，那个高速公路嘛，那个收费的嘛是袂好，那个 ETC 也袂好私立的，那是国家最重要的那个
收入
啊，民间的啊，对啊，哎呀，所以
到底
有
什么可以
交换的？这我就不知道，但是美国对于人权方面，这些美国发言。破关了，破关是要叫美国去偷啊，应该是啊，嘿啊。伊关于这方面的法律爱问秘书掉了，嘿啊，咱较不了解，嘿啊，所以讲我袂使讲太多。但是美国对人权方面，他是判决的时候，如果他像美国的有时候对人权判决的时候，他是判很重的哦，规个咧赔哦，哟。对啊，对啊，什么物件？啥赔人嘢？好，对对对，嘿啊。对啊，总些就破两亿啊，对吧？伊迄两亿是美金还是？哎呀，对吧？ 凊彩就就凊彩就就一个啊，系啊，所以讲啊，即摆咱对咱阮个是人权啦，啊伊破嘞，你看卖啊，即有，所以讲伊即摆挑工叫你卖办收济身份证，可能是安尼，附证啊，哦，可能搞你拖啊吼，因为咱即摆办身份证的人数越来越多，嘿，各位，我跟大家报告一下，现在办身份证的人数是愈来愈济哦，因为很多人他已经看到民政府。早期我在讲时，三四当前啊，较早秘书处在讲时阵，那是很小而已啊。啊，我们的同心现在这一年下来的努力，大家在外口开车在宣传啊，啊，搁夜骑啊在行路啊，哈、哦，即摆台北州、台北、台中、新竹、台南拢有在行，哦，啊，高雄较早是有车队，包括安排，哈、哦，咱安排的车拢在走，哈、哦。啊，即摆搁有一挂新闻出来，啊，有的人是看到这啦。有的人是看了这个，迄个战斗机落来时阵，伊我就问讲啊，你敢知这什么意思无？伊讲伊知啊，含你讲同款啦，美国军事占领台湾啦，系啊。所以讲，秘书长这条法律是百分之百是正确的，系啊。好，啊，你有收到九月一号的？你住哪里？基隆啊，跟高雄讲的一样。我是前天，一个高雄。一个单位的那个讲的，哦，对啊，对啊，九月一号的，哎，对啊，哎呀，所以现在中华民国他尽量做坤收之道，可以跟你拖多久算多久，拖一天是一天，哎呀，所以你们现在如果有亲戚朋友，你快点去讲这个身份证，以后对他绝对是一个保障。你我们执政以后，如果一定会有个一段时间，伊若不爱申请，伊阁使用中华民国身份证，他就不被台湾政府、台湾民政府保护着啊。这是合理的啊，你也不是咱的公民啊，我们就不可能享有那种公民的权利。所以讲，即摆你甲讲，就是讲好因骂，还是讲诈骗，你嘛是有着以后，好、哦，不是自私嘛、哦。你讲真的，现在很多人在外面讲，有的阿姨啊、阿伯、阿嬷吼，在外面讲这身份证，已经是，已经很怎么讲？受尽风寒了啦，已经被讲得讲到麻痹啊！但是嘛是继续在讲，为了台湾了呢，哎，啊，为了你们现在去跟他讲，是为了他好，不是为了好。我做这也无钱啊，讲就较白，你讲上就也没有钱啊，对不？就是为了因俩，为了台湾俩，吼、哦。所以讲，希望大家当下先，出去一定会被笑啦，吼、哦，一定有人笑啦，那好，如果即先生讲诶，对吧？先生讲诶，对吧？伊讲啊，恁是诈骗咯，还是啥诶？系啊，一定会讲，但是无要紧。诶，我们走这条路本来就很辛苦，诶，真理啊，好、哦，为真理而战。所以讲，很多人在民政府，我们同县很多人在里面没有薪水，而且工作也不是很好，但是他为了民政府，为真理而战，他心情很愉快，伊袂艰苦。嘿，就是讲互人骂，伊嘛袂艰苦咧，真的、哦。哎呀、啊，这是事实。哎，我们遇到太多了。哎呀、啊，
所以今嘛，报纸还是会形成一个时代的特征。你今嘛把你经济掉，把你控制掉的，啊，这嘛是额外的。
对，不，伊多伊是讲三等亲以内，三等亲以内才会使去申请。啊，可能是袂使写委托书上面的，应该是安尼吧？就是伊限制愈来愈济，可能是安尼啦。
三等亲都已经三代。嗯。
阿公、爸爸、囝安尼，囝阁会使请到阿公遐去安尼，应该是三点亲，不行，只能到父亲了。哦，安尼限制愈来愈侪。对，你就会使，你本人呢？本人呢？系啊。
这
样讲的。哎，对啊，哎呀、啊，所以讲快点去跟大家讲，要不然九月号很难请的时候会拖到我们的那个申请身份证的速度，哎呀、啊。规定什么条件？
伊会咱今麦会申请这个身份证。
嗯哼。
啊，政府单面政府是。
嗯。
会签这个合作嘛？
哎。
啊，伊今麦九月初到明仔日定什么条件，才会使？
无。嘿。
今麦有啥物啊？咱条。
我嘛唔知，伊就超工要调来，你王志伟若要甲你调来，你就奥多拜水，伊要甲你抽的时阵要甲你抽啊，对无？ 对啊，对啊。像你去申请，你讲这是我迄个权利啊，合法纳税人啊，对吧？啥那我袂使请，因为你是本人嘛，对吧？系啊，系啊。嗯，哦，所以讲各位还没去申请身份证的，快点去申请，嘿，去找郡办公室或者是州都可以，州吼，系啊，广州、台南州、台中州、新竹州，啊个台北州、宜兰州拢有，嘿，哦，啊各郡办公室都可以申请身份证。啊，希望大家回来的时候帮我们多多推广哦。现在剩还有三分钟哦，关于身份证方面有没有什么问题？哎，你只要比如说一方是中国人，一方只要持中华民国身份证，让你申请。嘿，他只是出来以后会有级别，比如说 PTW 啊 ，TW 就是本土台湾人，台湾公民。啊 PTW 的是一方是中国籍，一方是台湾籍，就是 PTW 准公民。啊，你像外籍新娘，他们有的是越南籍、印尼籍、菲律宾籍，他们一样是持中华民国身份证，他们有入籍嘛？我们一样可以申请，但是一路来行，他是分会依那个国籍，比如说 VN 就越南，然后印尼就是 ID 这样子去分，可能会先用这个居民哦，到底家人对吧？啊，以后再转，照人权方面，照人权公约来讲，再转到那个台湾公民，应该是这样。
中国新娘，
嘿，可以，只要持中华民国身份证的有入籍的都可以塞啊，嘿啊，都可以，嘿啊。哦，啊，如果是养父养母的哈，日治时，他是黄。他父母是养父养母，你就必须请到生父生母哦，生父生母哇，嘿，生父生母，比如说以他的爸爸是现在的爸爸妈妈是养父养母，你就必须追溯到生父生母，嘿。但是我假讲后盖你若讲从九月一号开始的话，户政遐就较不爱好给家你足侪规矩，就假讲足歹清的，嘿啊，嗯。好，关于身份证，各有啥问题吧？对，
嗯，
这是啊，咱是甲美国接进款，唔是甲中华民国接进款，系啊。嘿，嗯，无啊，咱赶快来，伊是想要住伫遮，咱就是用伊个国籍来分就好啊。啊，你是台湾的，你就是 TW， 你就享有台湾政府的台湾民政府的迄落。
嘿，啊，
免啦，伊若要一时主导，伊若要无住遮，伊就家己离开，伊就家己离开啊。哎，会使，哎，袂使。你若无请咱的身份证，阁要带遮，无可能啦。全世界嘛无可能这个代志。遣送就好啊，遣送等于金门妈祖就好啊。金门妈祖是伊个啊，金门妈祖是呢。即马金门建设了足水个啊，你有这嘿平潭啊，平潭甲金门妈祖啊，金门妈祖甲平潭。系啊，即马最近有人去金门无？即马金门建设了足水个。啊，个平潭足反常的哦。平潭它伊是较早是个小渔村，啊，埃克法签订以后，遐个阿没有人口，啊，即马大量建设，即马干啦台北市安尼，你无这不符合迄落效迄落经济效益啊？只要足侪人诶，只要有迄落才会起厝对无？伊迄当初阁无人，伊就起甲足水诶，迄落是要互因断伊
诶。嘿，
有啦，你若接进款警察也是你诶。叫伊走就走啊！哎，无哎，免烦恼，系啊，系啊。没啦，系啊。无啦，咱即款接到遐军，哎，警察拢咱的，军嘛是咱的啊，对无？嗯。无啊，哎，美国会处理。
哎。
唔，美国会处理，很免烦恼。
这个外地的，外地的朋友啦，
哈。嘿。 赶快来办，你就甲户籍成本去申请就有啊。嘿，申请，哎，出来嘛是迄落。嘿，对对，嘿，赶快。好，咱时间到啊，大家下课，就好休困。